I'm going to perform a neutralization reaction using hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. If you recall from the indicator section, that phenolphthalein will react with base and show a nice fuchsia color, whereas with an acid, it really doesn't react. So let's try that again. I want a drop of phenolphthalein in hydrochloric acid, nothing happens. The same drop in sodium hydroxide, I get a nice indication of the base, the OH ion in sodium hydroxide. So I've got them here. What exactly is neutralization reaction? Well, it's a double replacement reaction, if you wish, where we're going to have the sodium latching on to the chlorine and the hydrogen latches on to the OH group. And you could have it with any acid and any base. So always remember you've got an acid and a base in a neutralization reaction. So what will happen when we mix these together? We mix these together, and you notice that the pink disappears. Now, ideally, I was hoping I had the same concentration of acid and base, and I do. I've got about 0.1 molar of each, but my pink disappeared, so that means that I'm more acidic in this now than basic, than alkaline. So I'm going to add, notice that as I add a couple drops, you see that my sodium hydroxide is trying to mix in there and reach an equilibrium. At the point where my phenolphthalein will kind of stay or take longer to disappear, then I'll know that I'm really balancing out my sodium and chlorine ions. But right now, as long as my phenolphthalein is totally disappearing this fast, I know that I've got more HCl than sodium hydroxide. There we go. We're almost reaching equilibrium. If you see, it's taking longer for my pink. But let's say I fast forward here and see what I get the next day. The next day, I'm going to let this dry a little bit and fast forward to tomorrow. There we go. My water has evaporated and I have, oh my God, I have actual salt. NaCl and my H2O molecules have evaporated and leaves me with nice crystals of NaCl.